Anne Lynch is the CEO of Bello, is that right?
Bello.
Water. And basically, Karen launched a new business model focused on what can only be described as exceeding environmental standards in the industry, whilst pledging to donate all profits to WaterAid. And in the meantime, transforming thousands of lives with access to safe water and sanitation. Now, with Karen at the helm, the company has been recognised with many awards, including this year's Queen's Award in the Sustainable Development category. So you must be doing something right, Karen. And I know you've got huge amounts of experience built up over the years. So please give a very warm welcome to Karen Lynch.
Hi, good evening, everyone. Do we have any social entrepreneurs or aspiring social entrepreneurs in the audience? Decent percentage.
Yes, very good.
So, social entrepreneur or not, I hope there's something in the Bello business model that might inspire you to think a little bit differently with whatever business it is you're pursuing. So, how many of you are aware of Bello before coming tonight? In terms of, that's about what, I don't know, what, 50% maybe? Okay.
Is it usually that kind of figure?
It depends. Up north, it's less.
Yes.
Generally in London, it's a bit higher. But anyway, Bello, we supply mineral water in bottles. We supply filtration systems and carafes and refillable bottles to the UK's hotels, restaurants, corporate catering. So we're a business. We're 100% dependent on trading revenue. We don't get any grants or subsidies, but we're also a social enterprise because the business is asset locked. And all of those profits, as Nadine says, goes to WaterAid. But what's interesting is that the social mission actually isn't the starting point of the business. The business exists for two reasons. The first reason is to try and inspire all business that we can help solve some of the world's problems through the course of doing business. So, you know, to get rid of the idea that a few of us need to get really, really rich to then give a lot of money philanthropically, the idea that we can do it through the course of doing business, because it's only business that's going to solve the world's problems. And then the second reason is we wanted to drive positive change in one sector. So Bello as a brand is all about environment first. So as a business, we use recycled glass. We actually developed, through some vertical integration in supply chain, the lightest weight glass bottles using recycled glass in the UK. So we have a sister business, Ethical Glass. We pioneer and have the highest use of recycled plastic, the view being if we create a value for waste, it won't become waste, it becomes a resource and it won't go anywhere near an ocean, that we can use refillables when single use isn't necessary. Basically, everything that we can do to set the benchmark in the industry, because when you are smaller, it's easier to take a decision to do that. And most importantly, when your shareholders aren't waiting for a dividend, it's not always about maximising profits. But it is very important that we make profit. So we've done 6 full years. This is our 7th year trading as Bello, as you see it now, with WaterAid as our partner. And a very, very different model. I've been really focused on becoming debt-free because that liberates me to run the business differently. So up until December last year, we became debt-free and we passed over £2.2 million to WaterAid, which means this year, in this year alone, we'll be able to pass over £850,000 to WaterAid. Now, what's really interesting about that is it's a story about small can be really impactful. There are 8 of us. So for the mathematicians amongst you, £100,000 of net profit per employee is a KPI that I think any business, you know, could look towards and be proud of. So a very, very different model, not for everybody, but I have to say, versus my career in media, which I did love, those were the days though, followed by I spent 5 years in Barclays in finance and proposition development, and then a small stint at Audi Motors. This is just, it's the job that I was looking for to find my personal purpose, because I'm able to use the things that I learned along the way and got okay at or good at, but doing something good with it.
Well done, Karen. That's an amazing story, isn't it, actually, when you think about how inspiring that is. I think probably a lot of people know WaterAid through Glastonbury.
Yep.
That's probably the key thing. Are there any other businesses that support WaterAid in the way that you do? Is that quite a unique adventure for you.
So it's very innovative and very interesting to, I mean, because the idea that instead of giving £1,000, if you invested £1,000 in a social enterprise that would keep on giving, it's like magic, isn't it? The gift that keeps on giving. So as far, so WaterAid were pioneers in saying yes to this idea back in 2011, and that the rest of their businesses are traditional corporate partnerships. But this is the model that we're currently doing lots of work on trying to replicate in other product categories.
So what's interesting as well, because you've got a huge amount of experience from quite a few different industries, has that helped shape the business that you're in today? And in what way has it helped? So in terms of marketing and branding and media, how has that helped you make the most of Blue Water?
So mostly I do exactly the opposite of what I would have done in previous industries. And in Barclays, I'd have started with, right, I've got £3 million this trading period. How do I spend it best? Whereas, you know, we go, if £15 can transform a life long term, how do we do this without spending anything? It's very, in fact, I do a lot of work with big brands and their marketing teams go, if we had zero budget, what would we do? Because not all of our best ideas, but some of our best ideas come because we have little or very limited resources. But at the same time, theoretically, we could spend what we want. It's all about the return on investment. So one of our values is don't spend, invest. And it's a discipline that you'd think bigger businesses would do better, but they don't. There's the history and the habits. And we've formed some very frugal habits, which at the same time will have held us back in some way, right? I mean, you know, all businesses are different. And the next phase, I think, that we need to go through is actually challenge our own model and see what difference we can make.
So in terms of, you know, the audience out there, what's the most cost-effective way that you can maybe target the media or make the most of your very little marketing spend or no marketing spend at all in order to achieve the desired effect of getting your brand out there and getting it noticed?
I guess my biggest piece of advice would be, unless you particularly like being sold to, and I certainly don't go out and try and sell to people. Yeah, I think, you know, sales as we know it, and I still get a lot of those calls and a lot of people pitching, it's just miserable. You know, our philosophy is about how can we go out there and talk to people and inspire them to come and ask us something, because when that dialogue starts that way, it's very, very different. But, you know, we're all, you know, when we're passionate about something, it's really easy to go out there and just sell. And there's nothing worse than somebody ringing you up or popping around and it's not well researched. Whereas, and we haven't got all of the time in the world to research everybody that's on our prospect list to that level. Whereas when the shoe's on the other foot, it seems to make it just much more fruitful. So more marketing, less sell.
And I'd imagine for the hotels dealing with you or the hospitality sector, for their corporate social responsibility, when the proposition of Blue is brought to them, it's going to help them fulfil their targets as well. So it's a win-win. Have you found that that's the case?
So I think bottled water particularly is a very controversial subject. You know, theoretically, we don't need it. You know, in the same way, we theoretically don't need aeroplanes and cars. And there are lots of things we shouldn't do. But hey, real life and convenience and rushing around is there. Our philosophy is to be very clear on our target market, to understand it's their business and understand what they're trying to do and to support them in delivering that. So, you know, if they need to maximise their commercial revenues because that's where their business is at right now and they need to be able to pay the rent, or if they're moving to the next phase of reducing their environmental impact and they want to remove single-use plastics, whatever their objectives are, we'll help them deliver it with the lowest footprint possible.
Brilliant. I think it's a genius idea. Karen Lynch, everybody. Thank you very much, Karen.